Welcome to KCF's online church service. We're glad you've joined us. Please remember to like and subscribe.
Well, a very good morning to you, KCF Church, and welcome to Church Online. I greet you in Jesus' name, and we just pray that you have a blessed service with us this morning. But before we start anything, I want to wish KCF Church a happy, blessed 18-year anniversary today. Our church started in 2002, and I just want to say thank you to all the pastors, the leaders, the congregation, each and every one of you, whether it was people from the past or the present, for whosoever have contributed to KCF Church, to its well-being, to its ministry, whether it was big or small, in cash or in kind, whether in word or in deed. I want to say may the Lord bless you. And I say a big thank you to you for sowing seeds into KCF Church. And we want you to know that we are where we are because of the congregation and all those who have contributed towards the success of KCF Church. Notwithstanding, however, the role of the Holy Spirit and the divine providence of God in our lives, we know that, you know, through it all, in it all, God has been there to lead us, to direct us, and to guide us. And so we give Him the glory this morning. So would you bow your heads with me as we just pray and give thanks to the Lord. Hallelujah. So let's just pray. Our mighty God and our heavenly Father, hallowed be your name. May your kingdom come in our lives, in our church, and Father, may your will be done in all that we will say and all that we will do in the days, in the months, in the years, in the generations to come. May we be a church that will uncompromisingly preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, share the word that will touch hearts and lives of all those that will come to it in the name of Jesus Christ. And Father, we pray a blessing on all those who have contributed towards the success of KCF Church, for those who have sowed financially, for those who have sowed through ministry, for those who continue to remain faithful these 18 years. Lord, we bless them. I bless them this morning in Jesus' name. And Father, we pray that we will continue to be blessed, to be a blessing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And all God's people said, amen, amen. So what we do on every anniversary service, all the members of the church that have served in 7 consecutive years, we give them a 7-year commemorative framed certificate, one like this. And then for those who reach 14 years, we give them also a commemorative certificate like that. And then hopefully in the next 3 years, when we reach 21, then we will have a certificate for those who are in the church for 21 years. And so I'm going to just call out the names because given the situation right now, because of our current lockdown regulations, we can't do this in person. So I'm going to call out the names and we're going to put a picture, for behind those names so that you know who are these people that are receiving their award this morning. So the first person that has reached 7 years at KCF Church is, as a matter of fact, I think he was born in KCF Church. And this is Aaron Krishna, and followed by Agnes Skeppers, Astrid Jordan, Christina Govender, Elizabeth Swickland, Flossie Lutchman, Annelie van Dierventer, Catherine Nyker, Denzel Appelsamy, Deline Appelsamy, Mona Dennison, Nathan Marimutu, Natalie Williams, Nicholas Williams, Nisi Kasamuna, Priscilla Lowe, Ryan Munsami, Samuel Cupido, Sushila Cupido, Sean Barker, Teddy Pugana, and Vishnu Lutchman. Let's give the Lord a hand for them. Amen. Well done to all these folk who have served faithfully and been members of KCF Church for the past 7 years. Amen. And then we want to also do the 14-year certificates. And the first person to receive that is Solomon Moses, Maggie Hall, Samantha Hosking, Shakir Pillay, Zakir Pillay, and Stacy Bonnell. Let's give the Lord a hand for them. They are in the church for 14 years. Hallelujah. Praise God. Okay, so those are the folk that we wanted to just honor and bless. You know, the Bible says, planted in the house of the Lord, they will flourish in the courts of our God. And I pray that you continue to flourish at KCF Church and that you grow from strength to strength and do great and mighty things for Jesus Christ and for the kingdom of God. Amen. So we got a video that is going to be shown to you just now. But before we do that, I just want to just share a few announcements with you. And the first one is that I want all the ministry partners to take note that next week, the 16th of July, we have an online Sia Kula meeting for all the ministry partners. And so we will send you a link and help you to get connected so that we can have a meeting on Zoom. Amen. Then the other thing also I just wanted to just share with you and say thank you, you know, once again, for those who've given to the COVID fund that is helping give or make grocery parcels to the needy folk in our church. We have 160 people that we are blessing twice a month with grocery parcels. And I just want you to know that, you know, that right now all we're sitting with is like 9,000 rands. And that's just going to be enough for one more grocery parcel. And so we really want to encourage you to support the fund so that we can continue. Otherwise, we'll have to stop it. And so there are a lot of needy people out there. So I appeal to you to be generous to those of you who are blessed to give to the fund so that we can continue to be a blessing. Amen. And then also, I just wanted to say thank you to the faithful tithers of the church. You know, we pray for you all the time, for the business people and those people that faithfully tithe, you know, and to so that we can get, you know, keep on doing the work of the ministry and doing all that we are doing for the kingdom. So God bless you. Amen. And then the last thing I want to say is that, you know, we have an in-person service and the service is at 10 o'clock. But please take note, you know, if you are sick, if you've been with sick people, if you've been in contact with somebody that's got COVID, if you have elderly people in your home that is staying or people with pre-existing conditions, we really encourage you, please stay at home and watch online. Amen. But those that are young and healthy and you don't have any sickness and you don't have you know, you're not living with somebody that's sick or you're not living with the older parents, and come to church so that we can, you know, continue with fellowship. Amen. So that is all I wanted to share with you for this morning. So let's get ready to watch the 18-year anniversary video that we've made just to give you some of the highlights that has been taking place over this 18 years. Amen. So let's watch that.
Happy birthday.
Celebrating their birthdays this week. On the 17th, Basil McDonald and Serafin Kasemwana. On the 16th, Alicia Bugana, Celine Batchelor, Dylan Bart, Nomfundo Ngumzwayo, and Rosemary Chaka. On the 15th, Kirsten McDonald, Romano Sampson, and Sean Naidu. On the 14th, Talisha Pillay. On the 13th, Anthony Grunwald, Charles Esram, Sizwe Mabaso, and Skylar Lee. On the 12th, Casey Oliveira and Gabriel Davis. Celebrating their anniversaries this week, on the 15th, Ivan and Rina Singh. On the 14th, Clinton and Elizabeth Johns. And on the 13th, Rodney and Josephine Green.
Hi, Kids for Life! Today's memory verse comes to us from Ephesians 4, verse 32, and it says, "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you." Okay? So now we're going to add some actions to that. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ, God forgave you. Okay? So now we're going to do just the actions without the memory verse. Okay, great. So now we're going to do the memory verse and not the actions. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ, God forgave you. Okay, so now we're going to do them both, but with a little bit more oomph, okay? So, be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ, God forgave you. All right, guys, have a blessed week.
Good morning, Kids for Life. Our object lesson is on unforgiveness. Sometimes people make our heart feel sad or broken. A little broken, a lot broken. Sometimes we make others sad. Kids for Life, carrying around feelings such as anger and hurt are like bricks that represent unforgiveness in our lives. Unforgiveness makes us frustrated and upsets us. It makes us feel like a ton of bricks on your heart. It's like revenge, hate, bitterness, hurt, and anger. Then we ask Jesus to come into our lives, and we will be free of the burdens we are carrying. Only God makes a path for us to follow Him and let go. When we remove all the bricks from our lives, it becomes lighter and lighter. And we ask God to help us forgive them and mend our heart. Thank you, Kids for Life. Stay safe.
Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. As he began the settlement, a man who owed him 10,000 bags of gold was brought to him. Since he was not able to pay, the master ordered that he and his wife and his children and all that he had be sold to repay the debt. The servant fell on his knees before him.
Be patient with me,
he begged.
And I will pay back everything.
The servant's master took pity on him, canceled the debt, and let him go. But when that servant went out, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 silver coins. He grabbed him and began to choke him.
Pay back what he owed me,
he demanded. His fellow servant fell to his knees and begged him.
Oh, be patient with me. I will pay you back.
But he refused. Instead, he went off and had the man thrown into prison until he could pay the debt. When the other servants saw what had happened, they were greatly distressed and went and told their master everything that had happened. Then the master called the servant in. You wicked servant, he said. I canceled all that debt of yours because you begged me to. Shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant just as I had on you? In anger, his master handed him over to the jailers to be tortured until he should pay back all he owed. This is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive a brother or sister from your heart.
Hi, Kids for Life. In Ephesians 4, verse 32, the Apostle Paul encourages us to be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ, God forgave you. So many things can happen to upset us in a day, like a family member eating the last piece of chocolate cake you had planned to have for dessert, your brother or your sister wearing your favorite clothes or using your stationery without permission, your parents scolding you for something you did not do, or your best friend ignoring you for no apparent reason. Lewis B. Smith once wrote, "To forgive is to set a prisoner free and discover that the prisoner was you." Harboring bitterness and unforgiveness in your heart is emotionally draining and grieves the Holy Spirit. It traps you and stifles your spiritual growth. When we choose through the power and anointing of the Holy Spirit to walk in love and forgiveness towards others, then we are set free from the sinful bondage of unforgiveness. So, Don't wait for people to deserve it. You simply choose to be obedient and be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ, God forgave you. Goodbye, Kids for Life.
Stay safe. Wash your hands. Or sanitize. And wear a face mask.
Remember to stay safe and to keep on storing God's word in your heart, in your mind, and to do what it says.
Shout your name, Jesus, we make your name.
Well, amen. I trust that you enjoyed that worship. You know, God is a way maker. He made a way for us these 18 years, and I know that He's going to continue to make a way. And I encourage you to trust Him. Trust Him that He'll be your way maker too. Amen. So let's get ready to listen to the Word of God. And my sermon is taken from the book of Psalms, from chapter 1. And I'm going to read from verses 1 to 6. And the title of my message this morning is The Pursuit of Happiness. Amen. And so everyone wants to be happy. Some believe that wealth, prominence, prestige, power can give them happiness. But we all understand, we all know that money cannot give us happiness, or money cannot buy happiness. Someone once said that money cannot buy happiness, but it's more comfortable to cry in a Mercedes Benz than on a bicycle. You know, happiness for a believer starts in the heart. It's an internal thing. And as we begin to read God's Word and understand what the Word of God says, slowly as we pursue the Word of God and pursue happiness, we will find happiness and joy and peace through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So let's read in Psalms 1, and it says this: Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on His law day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do prospers. And then the Bible goes on to say, Not so the wicked. They are like chaff that the wind blows away. Therefore, the wicked will not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the assembly of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked leads to destruction. Hallelujah. So, first thing I want to say to you this morning, when the Bible says, blessed is the one, or blessed is the man, or blessed is the person, what does it mean? It means simply happy. So happy is the one, happy is the man, happy is the person who does not walk in the counsel of the ungodly, like the King James Bible says, or in the counsel of the wicked, like how the NIV Bible says. So what does it mean to, what does the word wicked mean? Well, the dictionary says this: morally wrong or bad. You use wicked to describe someone or something that is very bad, and someone that deliberately harms people. Or the definition of wicked is someone or something who is cruel or acts in an evil way. Now, what does it mean to be ungodly? Ungodly, it means those who deny or disobey God, those who oppose God or live contrary to the Word of God. Do you know that there are many Christians on a daily basis that are receiving counsel from wicked, ungodly people. You know, how can this be, you ask? Well, think about the number of hours that you spend watching television, watching Netflix, watching DSTV, watching SABC, watching videos. You know, the truth of the matter is this, is that most of those movies are made by wicked, ungodly people who have an agenda that when they make a movie, they have an agenda, they have a message they want to communicate through to you. And we watch these movies, we watch these programs as entertainment. And so their agenda is to desensitize the children of God. Their agenda is to normalize their immoral behavior. And their agenda is to change our views and our opinions of what is right and what is wrong. And so the Bible says, happy is the person who does not walk in the counsel of the ungodly or does not listen to the counsel of the wicked. Happy that person will be. I want to ask you a question. Why does God not want us to have anything to do or to be listening to ungodly counsel or wicked counsel or be watching, you know, programming that's done by ungodly, wicked people? Why? Well, the first thing is that he does not want us to believe what the wicked or the ungodly believe. You see, the wicked, by listening or watching movies or programming, that's made by wicked, we can get negatively influenced by them. Amen. The second thing is that God does not want us to behave like how the wicked behave or how the ungodly behave. Amen. Why? Because in 2 Corinthians 5:17, it says, if any man be in Christ, that man is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. And then the third thing is that God does not want us to belong with the wicked. We shouldn't be in the company of wicked people. Because in 1 Corinthians 15:33, it says, do not be deceived. Evil company corrupts good habits. Bad company corrupts good morals. So what must we do? Well, I encourage you, stop watching those movies that blaspheme the name of Jesus Christ, that use the name of Jesus Christ as a swear word. Movies that, are immoral and ungodly, we must stop watching them. You know, Netflix has deliberately, put a movie on Netflix that portrays Jesus Christ as a homosexual. And in spite of a million people that signed a petition to ask them to remove it, they refused to do it. You see, because they don't delight in God's word. As a matter of fact, they oppose God's word and they want to mock and ridicule our God. And you know, many times we just keep quiet about it and we do nothing about it. So the Bible says that we should not walk in the counsel of the ungodly or the wicked. And then the second thing it says this, it says that we should not stand in the way of sinners. What does it mean? You see, the phrase to stand means to do what sinners do, or standing where sinners stand. It carries the idea that, of somebody being a hindrance or blocking the way or being a stumbling block. And God does not want us to be a stumbling block to anybody, or he doesn't want us to be the stumbling block. Amen. And so the third thing, it talks about, sitting in the seat of mockers. Or sitting in the seat of the scornful. The thing about a seat is a position that you take. And, we can have a certain position, of Christians. We can have a certain position of people. Often we see people, criticizing others, mocking God, mocking God's word, mocking God's people. And God says, don't do that. Don't sit in the seat of mockers. Think about the things sometimes we say of other believers and how we can sometimes judge other believers who are in Christ. And many times on a public platform. You know, it hurts me to see when, you know, Christians criticizing other Christians, but they are silent when it comes to fighting the real enemy, the enemies of the cross. Children of God, we must choose our battles. There are many enemies out there. There are many battles out there we need to fight. But I find that far too often we tend to fight with one another. And so the Bible says, if you want to be blessed, if you want to be happy, don't do these three things. Don't walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Don't stand in the way of sinners. And don't sit in the seat of mockers. But one thing you must do, it says, you must delight in the law of the Lord of our God. But you must delight in the law of the Lord. And on this law, on this word, you must meditate day and night. So the first thing I want to talk about is to delight. What does it mean to delight? It means to take pleasure. In other words, the word has captured your full affection. It's captured your heart. You love to read the word. You know, in Psalm 119:103 and verse 103, it says, "How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth." You know, to delight also means to value the word of God. It is food for the soul. And Jesus said it, you know, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. You know, to delight means that, you know, you give your full attention to the word of God. You dedicate your time, you know, to studying the word of God and reading the word of God. Ask yourself this question. Does the word of God fill your thoughts? Do you find yourself reading the word daily as much as you consume food on a daily basis? You know, the Bible says we must meditate on this word. What does it mean to meditate? To meditate means read. To meditate means to reflect, to ponder, to memorize, to study. And why? Because meditating on God's word comes with a promise of happiness as well with the promise of prosperity. The Bible says, "He shall be like a tree that's planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever he does prospers." You know, like a tree, you'll be noticed. You know, men will know when you have spent time with God. You know, they will know that this person, you know, by the words that come out of your mouth, they will know that, you know, you spend time with Jesus. What does it mean to be planted by streams of water? It talks about your position in life, always drawing wisdom and strength from God in good times and in times of drought. You know, the droughts of life and the dry seasons never seem to affect the believer who was planted near streams of water. Amen. In Psalm 92 verse 13, and I quoted it earlier, it says, "Planted in the house of the Lord, they shall flourish in the courts of our God, and they will still bear fruit in old age. They will stay fresh and green." You see, it talks about the same principle of being connected and committed to a church as a source of wisdom and knowledge to live a fruitful and a blessed Christian life. Amen. And then it says that you will bring forth fruit in season. You know, you will be productive. You will be a blessing to all those around you. You know, like a fruit tree. You know, a fruit tree that is bearing full fruit. The birds enjoy its fruit. The animals enjoy its fruit. The insects enjoy its fruit. Man enjoy its fruit. Everybody benefits from it. And God wants you to be like the tree where those people, you know, that you are in the circle of will benefit from your wisdom, from your knowledge, from your, you know, love and forgiveness, and from your values and your opinions. You know, you'll be like that tree impacting the people that are around you. Amen. And then it goes on to say, whose leaf does not wither. You know, no matter what season of life you are in, you will always be hopeful and faithful to your God and your calling. Your leaf will never wither. Amen. You know, I find sometimes so many people, they get discouraged so easily in difficult, challenging times. And finally, the Word of God says this, that whatever it does will prosper. Amen. In other words, God will bless your personal life, your family life, your business life, your spiritual life, you know, your church life. Every part of your life will prosper. Amen. That isn't to say that you will not experience the challenges of life. But what it means is that through the counsel of God's word and through Jesus by your side, you will always overcome. Amen. So in conclusion, I want to ask you this question. Do you want to be happy? Do you want to be blessed? Well, there's three things you must not do. One thing you must not do. Don't receive counsel from wicked, ungodly people, either by speaking to them, either by watching movies and watching programming that are done by them. Don't stand in the way of sinners. Don't be a stumbling block. And don't sit in the seat of mockers, you know, judge people, criticize people, you know, take a position that you know, and mock people for who they are. But, you know, delight yourself in the word of God. Amen. So let's take whatever necessary steps to pursue happiness. We all want to be happy. Amen. And happiness just don't come. That's why, you know, we have to pursue happiness. And as we begin to read the Word of God, study the Word of God, you know, pray, we will find happiness through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. So a few questions I want to ask you. Have you been spending too much time watching ungodly movies, movies that, you know, cuss and swear and use Jesus Christ as a swear word, movies that mock our religion and mock our God? You know what? Don't do that. The second thing is, are you standing in the path of sinners, doing what sinners do? Don't do that. Are you sitting in the seat of mockers? Have you adopted a mindset of a person who mocks or disagrees with the Word of God or disagrees with God's people? Stop it. Amen. You need to repent and say, God, forgive me. For the Bible says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Hallelujah. And the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus, our Lord. So where do you need to make adjustments this morning? In which areas do you need to change? You know, if this book promises you happiness, wisdom, and answers for life's questions, why won't you read it? Why won't you read it? You know, if only we would spend time reading, I tell you, many of our problems, we'll find solutions to the answers without having to suffer. Amen. So can I ask you to bow your heads as we pray this morning? I trust that you are doing some introspection. And so I know that you have your opinions and you have your views and there's a lot of things that you don't know. But the Word of God is there to give you guidance and wisdom for life and for godliness. Amen. So let's pray. Mighty God, I thank you. I have shared your word with your people. Your word says that, Lord, Father God, that this word is sharper than any two-edged sword, is able to cut through bone and marrow, soul and spirit. You said your word is like rain that comes down from heaven and does not return to you without watering the earth. So is your word. It will not return to you void. May this word encourage, motivate, correct those that have been listening this morning. And I pray that even as we as a church have turned 18 years, that we'll be a mature church. We'll be a church that will do some deep introspection. And I just pray for each one that has listened to this message this morning. May they be better. May they make some wise choices. And may they stand up for truth and righteousness. May they choose their battles in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, I pray that as they read and meditate on your word, may they be happy. May they be blessed. May their families be blessed. May their homes be happy. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. God. God bless you. Thank you so much. And I just trust this morning that even for those of you who are prepared communion and you're ready to share communion, if you would just get it out. And this morning, as you take this cup and as you take this bread, you know, say to the Lord Jesus, forgive me for my criticism, forgive me for standing in the way of sinners, forgive me for taking ungodly counsel, forgive me for watching those things I know I should not be watching. And ask God, in the Bible says that if we confess our sins and we repent before God, God will forgive us. And as you ask God to forgive you, as I pray, I know that He will. Amen. So let's pray. So Father, I say thank you for this piece of bread that represents your body that was broken for us, and this cup that represents your blood that was shed for us. Every time we partake of it, we do it in remembrance of you, Lord. That, Lord, you died for all our sins, and that you want us to live a blessed life, a happy life, a successful, productive, fruitful life for you, Lord. You want us to be light in this world. You want us to make a difference in the lives of people we come into contact with. So this morning, Lord, we reaffirm our covenant with you. We reestablish our relationship with you. And Father, we choose to walk in righteousness and truth in the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Lord, we also remember all those that are not well, that even as they partake right now, wherever they may be, in faith, believing in the precious blood of Jesus Christ that was shed for them, believing in your word that says that by your stripes we have been healed, may they receive healing and may they receive a blessing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. So let's eat together and let's drink together. Well, thank you for spending this time with us on this special anniversary service. I trust that, you know, you've been encouraged with the word. And, you know, Jesus said, if anyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. When the rain came, when the wind came, when the storm came and, you know, fell on that house, it did not fall with a crash because it was built on a solid foundation. You'll be blessed if you hear the word and put it into practice. Have a blessed week. God bless you. Till next week again. Amen.
Thank you for joining us today. For more videos and more content, please press the subscribe and like button. Have a blessed week.